Alright, so if you think about to buy an action camera in 2021, you probably get in contact with those GoPro cameras. These are some nice small cameras with an incredible stabilization and a good image quality. And right now there are tons of cameras out there, including these newest GoPros like the Hero 9. But actually, what about older cameras like the 2019 GoPro Hero 7? Is it still worth it to buy such a camera? Well, for this video today, I've collected a couple of reasons why I think that the GoPro Hero 7 Black is still worth it to check out. So let's talk about that. Okay, so first let's talk about handling this camera. The GoPro Hero 7 is actually an easy to use camera, so yeah, you don't need to be a professional photographer or filmmaker to get decent content or to set up the GoPro in general. In my opinion, the GoPro menu is super easy to use, and even if you just want to use it in the auto mode, it's still great to get some good footage. So even if you don't really need any additional settings or modes, or if you don't really care about that in general, you can easily use this camera in the auto mode. But of course, even the older versions like the GoPro Hero 7 offers all kind of modes to set up the GoPro in manual. So for example, you can set up all kind of things like ISO, shutter speed, white balance, and you can even switch to a flat picture profile if you want to tweak the colors in the editing process. So this camera is actually really good for beginners and professionals because it offers all kind of things that you need to record some incredible footage. And just to mention that here really quickly, of course the newer versions of the GoPro offer some more features, but even though this is a 2019 model, it still makes it possible to use all kind of features for less money. And exactly, that's a perfect opportunity to talk about the price and the build quality of this camera. And yes, of course, the price is really important, especially if your budget isn't that big and you still want to get some good footage out of your action camera. But gladly, GoPros aren't that expensive, and no, you don't have to buy the newest version. Even older ones like the GoPro Hero 7 are great cameras. And of course, especially if you want to use the camera for outdoor activities, you need to think about the protection, and the GoPro Hero 7 is a tough camera. You can use it in all kind of situations, and in most cases you don't have to worry about this camera at all because the build quality is so extremely good. And yeah, these cameras are protected against all kind of stuff, so water, rain, dust, dirt. So if you're looking for a camera that won't break immediately, check out these cameras. Another great aspect we need to talk about is that these cameras are versatile. There are a lot of options that you can use, so multiple video shooting modes, and even if you like to take photos, you can use the GoPro Hero 7 as well. Of course, I need to mention that I mostly don't use my Hero 7 to take pictures at all, because for high quality photo sessions I always use my Canon EOS R or R5. But especially if you don't have a big camera with you or you can't reach your smartphone, you can still take pictures with this camera. But actually, what's about the image quality? Well, in my opinion, the overall video quality is absolutely amazing for an action camera from 2019. It can shoot in all kind of 1080p and up to 4K video formats, so there's everything that you need, and you can even take some basic images with it. Of course, if you would buy one of the newer versions that are out there, you would get some more features like shooting RAW photos or some improved video recording options. But in my opinion, even though this camera is a couple of years old, I think you can still get some great footage out of this camera. But what I really like about the GoPro Hero 7 Black is the image stabilization, or the so-called hyper smooth feature. This one is such a great feature, and it makes it possible to record some nice footage even though if you're running around. And that's one of the most important things you should care about if you want to buy a camera like that. I never had any problems to record some good footage with this camera, so if you're looking for a budget version, definitely need to check out this camera. But yeah, now let's move on to another really important aspect, and this one is all about accessories. And a good aspect here is there are already a lot of great accessories out there, including full sets for a really low price. But a quick tip here is, if you like to record POV videos, I highly recommend to get the official GoPro chesty here. Because in my opinion, this one is way better, and it got this soft background, so it's not that uncomfortable while running around. I personally tested the plastic one first, and I definitely need to say that I don't like them at all, and that's why I've invested some more money to get this one here. This one here is super soft, the build quality is absolutely amazing, and you don't notice it while running around, and that is really important if you want to record some POV videos. But yeah, in all kind of other situations, it's not a huge problem to find some cheap accessories to mount the camera on all kind of things, for example. And of course, if you want to record some videos in 4K, for example, you need storage. And especially if you're out there recording all kind of activities, it's not that easy to make a backup on a hard drive or to actually notice that your camera stops recording because the SD card is full. And exactly, that's why I highly recommend to buy SD cards at least with 128 GB or even more. This totally depends on what you want to do. But the good aspect here is that storage is cheap. Currently you can get them for around $20 to $30, and that's a huge advantage. For example, my CF Express card for the R5 here is way more expensive. This one costs around $450, so that's a huge difference here. In the end, I highly recommend to get at least one or two SD cards with 128 GB or more, so you won't run into any problems and then you're set. But yeah, in the end I just need to say that even though this camera is a couple of years old, it's still a good camera for all kind of outdoor activities. The build quality is top notch, the accessories are cheap, and the footage looks great even though if you use the built-in auto mode. So if you don't want to spend that much money on a newer version, you can still buy one of these older versions as well. Okay, so yeah, these are my thoughts about the GoPro Hero 7 Black in 2021. So thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new, don't forget to smash that subscribe button to stay updated for upcoming videos, and I'll see you in the next video.